Hi everyone. I'm starting the show. So I came to do this piece with a basketball. You'll notice I called it ball change because I was being really clever. Apparently, when you leave a basketball in a cold car, it can explode. Did you know that? Now you did, and now I do too. Yeah, I look like I play, but I don't actually play, so I didn't know that. My dad was like, yeah, did you know it can explode? I said, no, I didn't know. So, the show must go on. So, I'm gonna recite a poem that I wrote about Fred Astaire, because that's appropriate. Hey, does anybody know whose birthday it is today, by the way?
Fred Astaire.
No. That's a good guess, Peter.
Money breaks?
No.
It was yesterday.
Oh. And today is Tommy Toon.
Whoa! Oh. Yeah.
Yeah. One person, yeah. So I'm going to read you a little poem that I wrote about Fred. And then I'm gonna dance for you a little bit. And you'll have to come see the basketball some other time when it's fully formed. So. It goes like this. In swing time, Fred and Ginger float across the floor, punctuating swinging phrases with toe tips and tight turns. Step, hop, step, hop, step, step, step. Spat-shod feet that click in unison. Playful moves that look so effortless. Fast footwork that seems so natural. They move as one. Their feet just barely graze the floor as they glide about it, cheek to cheek, embodying every last drumbeat, tapping rat-a-tap tattoos with grace and poise and grins. And as they finally sail over the railing and out the door, you can still see the swing in their step and the swing in their spirit. Thank you.
Thank you. Was again seen mumbling, eyes downcast, her fingers nervously pattering. Shadows dance around me as I teach my puppet's body a livelier allegro. A doll is always more beautiful than a thinking portrait that I keep with me as not to forget who I am. More beautiful since she nurtures the desire to discern between and track dynamic multiplicity of divergent demands. Contradictions lead her to the opposite movements, while dialectics of her thought steals presence from a latent plot development. Action, like a diminished version of what could have taken place, fades and becomes the mere hint of itself. Thank you.
videli kako mrmlja obrnog pogleda, nervozno dobujući prstima.
Senke igraju oko mene da kučem lutkarsko telo, dinamičan alergiju. Lutka se uvek lepša od micanog pokreta što ga nosim.
Charlotte a été de nouveau vue, marmonnant les yeux baissés avec ses doigts, tapotant nerveusement. Les ombres dansent autour de moi, tandis que le salut.
Thank you. Bit, just get the torso going. Go ahead, I'll wait. I already warmed up back there, but it's chilly everywhere. Oh, there's somebody. My name is Peter, and I'm very grateful to have this opportunity to share this dance. It's very old, and I made it. I was telling Carol earlier, I made it because at the time I was a younger choreographer. I was making lots of big moving pieces, kind of like in Mark Morris' Wannabe Land, you know? And I made a series of small little dances about my family. And I thought, oh, these were just filler, you know. And as I've gotten older, nobody remembers those other dances at all. And they remember these. So I'm closer and closer to the age my father was when he wrote me a letter. And when I got the letter, I thought, well, this would make an interesting dance piece someday. But it takes place in a kitchen. And I think most of us have kitchens in our past, right? So if you could do a favor for me, just like you stretched, you just maybe close your eyes or glaze them over a little bit. And just think of the kitchen that you grew up in. Where's the stove, the refrigerator? What color are the walls? Is there a fireplace or not? We weren't that wealthy to have a fireplace in the kitchen. Is the dog's dish in the corner? What color are the appliances? You can open your eyes if you'd like. In my kitchen, the appliances were olive green. It was that era, you know. And the wallpaper, even though it was the 60s and 70s, wasn't as colorful as this lovely drapery. It was the yellow and brown plaid, just like in the Partridge Family, you know, the yellow kind of plaid thing, and then the big daisies or something like that. In front of me is the refrigerator, the sink window view of Mrs. Sherwood's house next door. She's the one who gave me the holiday themed cupcakes, the little snowmen or little hearts shaped on them, and she had a lot of cats. There were a row of cabinets here and the cereal cabinet here where my father kept his gallon jug of Carlo Rossi Chianti with the screw-off top. This is before screw-off tops on bottles of wine were in vogue. There, the dog's dish, our dog's dish underneath the chair here, the refrigerator again, and all that. The house is in rural Illinois. My father is chief of police of our little town. He was born in Orient Heights, met my mother, moved to this little place where we were considered diversity, dark-skinned Italians among the Danes and the Swedes and Germans. So this is Dad's letter. September 1983, dear Pete, it's 53 degrees out, almost summer. Promises to be warm this weekend. And cool again on Monday. It was Dallas and then Falcon Crest on the old squeeze box. That Dallas goes round the same old merry-go-round. Greed, family feuds, the fighting of those Ewing brothers. There was an excellent series, The Blue and the Gray, on the Civil War. Rebels and Yanks, brothers and cousins, fighting against each other. One young man refused to fight. He drew sketches of the war. Instead, he became a war correspondent. I guess you've heard by now that old George down the street has hanged himself. A neighbor found him in his shed last Saturday. I guess he knew what he was doing, as he had the dog put to sleep the weekend before, so you see things still happen in your old home town.
I want to go to Italy.
Rome, Italy. I said this to your brother and he laughed. I said, what's so funny about Rome, Italy? He laughed some more. I told your mother that I didn't think anybody loved us anymore. And she laughed. Hi, Pete. Good to see you in the show in Iowa. I'm rushing to send off a couple of packages Tuesday or Wednesday, so. Be on the lookout. Your father decided to make some gnocchi and boiled about 3 pounds of potatoes to do so. I guess this was. Quite a bit too much as he had flour all over the kitchen. Couldn't soak it up to make the potato dumplings. Look out for that package Tuesday or Wednesday. Love, Mom. And Dad. Your mother. I told her I didn't think anybody loved us anymore. It's weird to be alone on Thanksgiving. And she laughed. Why does everybody laugh when I... Close now. Pepper, she's pacing near the back door. It means she wants to go out. And Cal, our new boarder, he's renting the second room. Says he's going uptown for one of those burritos with that green gunpowder sauce. Yo! Ring that mechanic, friend of Joe's. Old George's Caprice is still in his driveway.